slave population here. They were mulattoes. They was the Spanish word, of course. And they were also quadroonists, with one quarter black and Anglo. And they were Octoroons, which is 1/8 black and Anglo. Now, the men were of no particular value, but the ladies of these ethnic groups possessed tremendous beauty, and they were absolutely sought after as mistresses. Now, this is where it gets really interesting. It was not only a common practice, but it was accepted by society. The church turned its back on it. They knew that the wealthy Americans wanted the Creole girls, the Octoroons, for mistresses. Twice a year, at the old French Opera House at the corner of Bourbon and St. Peter, they would have these very opulent Octoroon balls. These young ladies would be introduced to society, to the wealthy Anglos here. Now, the Anglos lived on the other side of the canal, so they didn't come down. The two factions, they couldn't agree on what time of day it was. Nevertheless, if a young gentleman was introduced to a lady, and if he was, in fact, interested, boom, in creating any kind of liaison with this young lady, from that point forward, after the proper introduction was made, all of the negotiation, so to speak, to create this liaison afflicage went through the young lady's mother. The gentleman was required to furnish a house, carriages, horses, staff in the house, furnishings, all the financial support she needed, and he was expected to do this. The children of this liaison took the name of the gentleman. Absolutely. Come on. Come on up. Come on up. Yeah. In the event that the gentleman decided to withdraw from this liaison, of this arrangement, so I should say, everything belonged to the lady. It was like being married without being married. You had to maintain. Come on. And this, up until the very early 1900s, they still had